Greeble is the art of adding complexity to give an impression of scale. Let's start by adding a plane and attaching two subdivision surface modifiers to it. These modifiers give the plane enough vertices to articulate the details we will soon be adding using a method known as displacement mapping. For the displacement mapping to work properly, let's go to the render settings and set the render engine to cycles, then create a material for the plane. And in the settings, set the surface to include both displacement and bump. Now, let's head over to the shading viewport, where immediately we're going to delete the principled BSDF shader and replace it with Blender's simple glossy shader. Then, let's add a texture coordinate node, a mapping node, a wave texture node, a color ramp node, a math node, and finally, a displacement node. This branch of nodes transforms our flat plane into a corrugated surface, which will be the base level of the Greeble. Using the wave texture, we can set the corrugations to be either along the X or the Y axis. The multiplier of the math node allows us to determine the depth of the corrugations. To generate the next level of Greeble, let's add a Voronoi texture node, a color ramp node, two math nodes, and finally, a mix RGB node. This set of nodes adds a solid plating on top of the lower corrugated plate. On the Voronoi texture node, make sure to select the Chebyshev option and use the displacement output. The math node that comes after the color ramp node allows us to set the thickness of the top plate using the multiplier value. The second math node evaluates the maximum between the two input values and as a result places the new flat plating on top of the corrugated one. Finally, the mix RGB node enables us to give each layer of plating a different color. Now, to add some detail to the top plate, let's duplicate the previous set of nodes using Shift-D and then add a math node. Here, make sure to increase the scale of the Voronoi texture. This branch of nodes uses the output of the Voronoi texture node to generate smaller details, which are then added to the top plate. Now, in order to add another layer of plating, this time to give the impression of surface repairs, let's duplicate the previous set of nodes and then add a math node and a mix RGB node. Here, on the Voronoi texture, instead of displacement, make sure to use the color output. The result of these nodes is added on top of the previous ones through the math node. At the same time, the mix RGB node allows us to set the color of this top plating. Now, to add some scattered lights to the model, let's add a math node, along with Blender's emission shader node and a mix node. Here, set the math node to compare the first input value with a small constant value of 0.005. This means that if the input is larger than the constant, the output will be zero, and the mix shader node will use Blender's glossy shader. However, if the input is less than the constant, the output will be 1, and the mix shader node will use Blender's emission shader. By changing the constant of the math node, you can increase or decrease this lighting effect. If you're interested in creating other sci-fi effects, I recommend watching these other videos.